Good afternoon, everyone. Jim Davis here, coming to you from the Fluke Networks Technical Assistance Center in lovely Everett, Washington. So we really appreciate the feedback that you've given us on our videos, and we're always looking for new content, new issues to discuss. And a question that I've been getting more and more recently comes from customers who are working in an industrial environment. And in those industrial environments, they have an interest to take Ethernet out to the edge, down to the factory floor, replacing older bus technologies. And the question has come up, what test limits should I use for this? Well, it's not our place as Fluke Networks to tell you what test limits to use. You have an architect, a consultant, perhaps the manufacturer of the cable who can recommend that for you. But I'd like to clarify for you some of the different options that we have. A lot of times it's going to come down to who terminated the connector. Was it terminated in a factory? You see this beautiful overmolded termination on this connector? Or did you have the, well, I'll blame the new intern, but yeah, it was me who crimped on this connector to the end. Well, this is going to have an impact on what test limit you use. When we are running a channel test, the channel test doesn't include the mated next of the plug and the jack. We actually start the test right here. That's great if you have a patch cord that was built in a patch cord factory. Now, if you crimped on the connector, you really want to look at the mated next of this plug. Was this plug properly installed? So if we use a channel adapter, that's not going to work well for us because we're going to start the test up here. What you need to use if you have installed the plug are patch cord limits. Patch cord adapter in the case of the RJ45 connector. Now, there's a very special jack in here that has special known electrical characteristics. And we're going to start the test down here. We're going to include the mated next of this plug with this jack. Great. Well, what about in the situation where I'm using, again, an industrial environment? So I'm going to be using a more heavy duty. Here I've got a 600 volt cable. No, it's not going to run 600 volts. It's designed to be next to 600 volts. It may have a special jacketing material that's more resistant to mechanical stress, even sunlight or toxic chemicals that may fall on it. Now, the RJ45 is perhaps not the best connector if there's going to be a lot of vibration or stress on the connector. So a lot of times in industrial environments, I find them using these round connectors. These are called an M12. This is actually a new one. This is the M12 X code, X for Roman numeral 10. It's designed to run at 10 gigabits. For many years, we've used the M12 D code connector, D for data, so I'm told. Well, again, the same situation where this was installed in a factory. We can see this nice overmolding, and we could use a channel limit when we're testing this. But what I hear from people is they buy this in a pre-made length, and it's a little bit too long, and they have some slack. Well, I don't want slack sitting around on the factory floor. It's not like I can hide it in the ceiling like I can here in the office. So I may cut one end of this off, and I may field install a connector. Let's take a look at this M12 field installed connector. Now, because this connector was installed in the field, I want to look very carefully at the termination. I want to measure the mated next between this plug and the jack. I could use a patch cord limit, but there's a problem. When I have this longer cable, if I use the patch cord limit, sometimes we start to see failures at low frequency levels. When we do a permanent link test, we compensate for this with the 3 dB rule. So with the ISO, the International Standards Organization, 11801-3, that is the cabling standard applied to industrial environments, they're working on a draft standard of a very interesting limit, something that's called end-to-end. Let's take a look at that here. So I'm going to change my test limit. I'll drill in here. I'll edit the test limit I have configured. Now, my default cable is an unshielded cable. Many times in an industrial environment, we're going to use a shielded cable because we're worried about electromagnetic interference. So let's select a shielded cable here. All right, now for my test limit, I'm going to go to more. I'll swipe up and here are these end-to-end limits. In the ISO world, rather than talking about category 5 or category 6, they have category D, which is more or less equivalent to Category 5E, and then they'll have Class E, which is more or less equivalent to a Category 6. Because I'm using the four pair, the X-coded connector, I would like to run a Class E test. So we'll select our Class E limit, and save, use selected, push test to start. That's a pretty complete test. It's going to take a few seconds for us to run here. Now, when we see this test result, one of the very important things that we're going to be testing is to make sure there's continuity of the shield. Again, we want to make sure the shield goes from one end to the other. So when I check my wire map, I can see I do have continuity of the shield. The DSX platform has an excellent shield test when we're working with four-pair cable that can tell us the distance to where a shield might be open. So again, we've run our sequence of tests, passed them. This connector was properly installed. We've measured the mated next of this plug and this jack. So I appreciate your time for listening to this introduction of the difference between a channel test, does not include the mated next of the plug in the jack, so that would be for a factory installed connector. The patch cord test, if you're using a field installed plug, we'll use a patch cord adapter. The M12 adapter works for both patch cords and channels. If I have an M12 cord with a factory installed plug, I can use a channel test. And with this field installed plug, I could use the patch cord test, but I find that with longer lengths of cable, the new draft end-to-end limit gives me the visibility of this connector that I'm looking for, along with the 3 dB rule to help me pass on long cables. My name is Jim Davis, coming to you from the Fluke Network's Technical Assistance Center. Have a good afternoon.